Hey there, my name is Sosonis and welcome back to Pixhawk. Just a few more days and then the game is getting released on Xbox One and on PC for early access. And since PvP is going to be a thing on Pixhawk, you wanna know how to defend your base against all those raiders, but also on PvE it is important to defend your base. So let's go in depth and let's see what we can find about base defenses. There are many ways to defend your base once you have built a base, and one of the ways to defend your base is by the use of auto turrets. Auto turrets are the things that you can see here on your screen. You need to put bullets in them, so you need to craft bullets, and also you need a generator for electricity because they run on electricity. And I don't know if there will be a limit on the turrets. I think there will be, because in Ark Survival we have now a limit of 100 turrets in a certain area. And my feeling says that Pixhawk is doing the same thing. And if you want to have auto turrets, well, you need to have a lot of resources, because you need to make the bullets, you need to make the auto turrets, you need to have electricity, the generator and all that kind of stuff. So this is more for later in the game, but there are plenty of other ways to defend your base earlier in the game. And what are the other ways to defend your base? Well, with the use of plants. Just like in Ark Survival Evolved, you have plants to defend yourself. In Ark Survival Evolved you have, for example, the plant species X that can spit at you, that can poison you and kill you. But you also have plant species Y that can trap you, and you have plant species Z, but these don't do anything for your base defenses. And where Ark Survival Evolved just has two plants that you can use for base defenses, Pixhawk has 7 plants that you can use. 7! Oh my god, and they are amazing, they have amazing abilities, so let's go check them out. And like I've mentioned in previous Pixhawk videos, a lot of stuff that I can find about Pixhawk is low quality screenshots and videos. So I'm sorry for that, but let's check out the first plant. The first plant is the Ivy, which you can find in the grassland area. And the model of the Ivy looks very similar to the model of the plant species Y on Ark Survival Evolved. The abilities of the Ivy are similar to the abilities of the plant species Y traps that can be harvested from the plant species Y when it is fully grown up. I don't know if the Ivy will also produce traps that you can harvest and that you can plant for yourself, but it will defend itself. And the way the Ivy defends itself is by producing vines. It will bury these vines under the ground and it will entangle you when you pass by. So it will grab you and then you need to chop your way out, I guess, or you just have bad luck and you're stuck there forever until you die. And it says it can also spit out special ones. It doesn't say what these special ones do. Maybe it spits it out and when you're not trapped by a vine, you get trapped by that thing that it spits out. But at least the vines are tied to people who pass by them, turning wild adventurers into their fertilizer. At least that is what the translation says on the Chinese website. And like I said, this plant can produce something called vines, and the translation on the internet says bury it on the ground, entangling you while you pass, and can also spit out special ones. So maybe we can harvest these vines from the Ivy and put them in the ground to set up traps, just like the traps of the plant species Y in Ark Survival Evolved. And that the special ones that it spit out, that those are little grenades of vines, and when you get hit by it, you get trapped in place. Maybe that is how it works. But nonetheless, you can use the Ivy to trap people and maybe also smaller creatures. The next plant we're gonna check out is very similar to the plant species X of Ark Survival Evolved. And in Pixhawk, this plant is called the Eaten Flower. This is a weird name, and I think in the game it will be called different, but yeah, we have to deal with a Google translation of a Chinese website. And this Eaten Flower you can find in the swamp area. The abilities of the Eaten Flower are very similar to the abilities of the plant species X in Ark Survival Evolved. It will spit poison balls at you that will damage you and also blind you. And if you get close enough, it will also start biting you. Yes, this plant will bite you. So it is even more dangerous than the plant species X on Ark Survival Evolved. Another plant that we can use for base defense is the Nepenthes. And the Nepenthes, hello Simba. The Nepenthes that we have in real life can be small to trap insects, but also can be really huge, as you can see in this picture. However, the Nepenthes in Pixhawk are a little bit different than the ones in real life, so they don't trap you. No, they spit out huge spores at you. These spores will slow you down, but they also do a lot of damage, also to nearby enemies. And because it is slowing you down and does a lot of damage, they say that if you get hit by it, it is too late, you cannot escape anymore. A few more extra hits and you will be dead. So I think this is an awesome plant to use as a base defense. And these Nepenthes you can also find in the swamp area. Another plant that you can find in the swamp area and use as a base defense is the giant nasty flytrap. and this plant has two heads with massive teeth that will bite you once you get close enough. And these plants really reminds me of those red evil plants that you can come across in Super Mario. This plant doesn't have a long range attack, but it has another special ability. If you hurt it enough, it will curl up and disguise itself. I don't know what they mean with disguise itself. Will it become another plant or something? Because if you use long range attack to attack this one, it will disguise itself, but you know that it is right there, so you can finish it off. I don't think this plant will move. And they say once it is curled up and disguised and you get too close, you will die. I don't know if it has a massive attack once it is curled up and you get close enough, or yeah, that it is just starts biting you again. But yeah, it has to be a deadly plant when it is curled up and you get too close. And if you go to the magical forest, you can come across special mushrooms. And these are called spore mushrooms. And these spore mushrooms are not that big, but once you get close, they will expand and grow. And once they are fully grown, they go poof and release a toxic cloud of glowing spores. And they say that these spores will make you constantly drop blood, slow you down, and they are poisonous. And I don't know if dropping blood means you will get a bleeding effect on you, because we haven't seen any blood in this game yet, but at least you will lose health, it will slow you down, and it will kill you if you stay long enough in this poisonous cloud of glowing spores. So in some way the abilities are a little bit similar to the abilities of the mushrooms that we have in Ark Survival Evolved, the Aberration DLC. And if you go to the Magical Forest to get yourself some spore mushrooms as a base defense, be sure to pick up the next plant as well. This next plant is called the Magic Ling. The looks of this plant are already evil, and this evil plant will have a ranged attack. And this ranged attack, it will throw huge poison balls at you, it will inflict damage, it will poison you, and yeah, you will slowly die. They don't say if it will slow you down, if it will blind you, but at least it has a ranged attack and it is poisonous like many of those other plants that we have seen before. And I think the range of this plant is really big, because in a translation they say, in the distance, I discovered that suddenly I was poisoned by blood and died. Well, I think that can be translated as, yeah, from a big distance of this plant, I got poisoned by it and then died. So I think this plant has a bigger range than the other plants. And to get the next and final plant of the base defense plants, you have to grab your fur armor because you go to the cold region, the icebound land, the permafrost region. It is really cold there, it is really dangerous over there, but there is an awesome plant. And this awesome plant is called the Ancient Wang Lian, the Ancient King Lotus. And this plant is special because it has a long range attack, but it doesn't spit anything out at you. No, no, it will grab you from a distance. It is using its tentacles to grab you with a whiplash attack. And when you cannot escape anymore, it says, it is really weird how the translation is. It says, when you haven't had time to escape, the slender plant grows on your body like a queen. What the freak does this mean? I don't know. I think it will just grab you and maybe pulls it towards itself and yeah, then you slowly die. Or yeah, you get something all growing on your body like, for example, the leeches in Ark Survival Evolved. I don't know what this is, but it is really weird. And I think a lot of you want to have this plant. And why is that? Well, maybe not for the attack ability, but for the other special ability. The special ability that it can heal you. It says that the Ancient Wang Lian will be able to restore the lives of its own camp characters around it. So this means that this plant can heal you, it can heal your tribe mates, and maybe also your tames. So I think you want to have this one in your base, especially on PvP when you get raided and kind of things. Have enough of these plants around you and you will get healed. So this ability is very similar to the wild plant species set that can be found on the Aberration DLC of Ark Survival Evolved, because these wild plants will heal your tames when you get close to them. So now you see that Mother Nature in PixArk is not only really cruel and hard, she can also be really nice to you for providing these natural organic base defenses. And if you thought that these were all the base defenses in the game, well, no, no. There is more. There are the Thunder Totems. And maybe there are also other variants of the totems, but for now there is only the Thunder Totem. And I don't think that these totems are really that powerful, that strong. We can see that it is killing a dodo, and here we can see a gem spider attacking them, but the player is killing the gem spider. But the totems are also really weak, because they get easily destroyed by the fire magic of this player. But these Thunder Totems, can they be good? Well, I think they can, because there are lightning storms in PixArk, and lightning storms will cause players to get stunned. And when you wear flak armor or metal armor, you get stunned even faster. So my guess is that these Thunder Totems will sap players and these players are getting stunned and then you can easily kill them. So I think that is the use of the Thunder Totems. And if that is the case with the Thunder Totems and you don't want to get stunned by them or by the lightning storms, you just have to wear your lightning helmet and you don't get stunned by lightning. Well, that wraps it up for this video. I hope you learned something new about base defenses and that it can help you with your adventure on Pixark. Don't forget to join me on my Discord, hang out there with me and other awesome people. And also follow me on Twitter so you can stay updated with everything that is going on with me and my channel. All we need to do now is wait a few more days and then we can start our adventure in Pixark. So that's it for this video. I hope you all enjoyed. If you did, leave a like, leave any thoughts about this video or whatever in the comment below. And as always, if you haven't already and want to see more in the future, then smash that subscribe button like a maniac. And I will see you all in the next video. Bye-bye.